It's been a few years since we've driven the AMG GTS coupe, and now it's time for this GT R Roadster. And what this thing seems to be is the best of modern day Mercedes-Benz combined with the best of modern day bonkers AMG. Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Makse, racing driver and lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for driving enthusiasts like us. Now, this Mercedes-AMG GTR Roadster is a unique piece in the lineup in that it's the top end, or among the top end, of AMG's performance range for the GT. But what I love about it is that it's got all of the modern conveniences of any top-end Mercedes-Benz combined with a completely mad drivetrain, making this one very unique roadster. Powering this GTR Roadster is AMG's very well-known handmade 4-liter twin-turbo hot V dry sump V8. And in GTR tune, it makes 577 horsepower at 6,250 RPM and 516 pounds of torque from 2,100 to 5,500 RPM. I actually think it makes more than that. The transmission is AMG's 7-speed dual clutch gearbox, and it is fantastic. In the back, there's an electronically controlled limited slip diff, and these things are magic. As well, the GTR gets dynamic engine and transmission mounts. The chassis is a basic steel structure finished in steel and aluminum. It's worth mentioning that there is a lightweight carbon fiber brace underneath the car made by the good folks at Multimatic, the Canadian engineering powerhouse. The bodywork is a couple of inches wider than the standard AMG GT to fit the wider wheels as well as give it a more aggressive look. As well, there's a bit of active aero going on underneath the car that is drive mode and speed dependent that adds a bit of front downforce. It's not obvious when you look at the car, we'd probably have to get underneath it, but AMG has paid special attention to airflow in and around this car for both downforce and, more importantly, systems cooling. I don't doubt that the adjustable rear wing is effective, but it does look a bit odd on this convertible. The suspension is double A-arms all around with adjustable coilovers in all four corners. Very, very cool. With adaptive dampers, of course. Brakes, as you can see, are carbon ceramics. 400 millimeter rotors in the front with 6-piston calipers and 360 millimeter rotors in the back. In total, that saves about 33 pounds of unsprung weight, which is massively important because it allows the dampers to do their job so much better and keep those tires in contact with the road. Wheels are forged, of course, and measure 19 by 10 in the front and 20 by 12 in the rear, wrapped in 275 front and 325 rear super sticky Michelin Pilot Sport Cup 2 tires. These things are amazing. Steering is hydraulically assisted with a variable ratio and variable assist. The rear wheels do a bit of steering as well. Correctly, the rears turn out of phase to the fronts at lower speeds for easier maneuverability when parking, and in phase at higher speeds for better stability. Very trick. Perhaps coming from AMG's expertise in racing, the drive modes are ridiculously sophisticated, perhaps the most I've seen. And in fact, there are 9 separate settings for traction control. We'll get into the drive modes a little bit later, but this thing is remarkably sophisticated. Inside the cockpit, one of my favorite features is the Dynamica or suede-like steering wheel covering. It's good stuff and perfect here. The GTR Roadster tips the scales at 3,700 pounds, but that's really not the story. What the story is static weight distribution, 47% on the front axle, 53% on the rear axle. And the reason is the engine is set so far back in the chassis, it's well behind the front axle. And as a driver, that sets you up for success. Yes, we know on this channel that static weight distribution doesn't define a car's handling, it's how you use it. But here, it really sets you up for success. If you're an experienced driver like me, you're gonna love this thing. It's that time in the episode 4, how to spec your Mercedes-AMG GTR Roadster. Base price in the United States is $189,750. In Canada, it's $239,900. Notable options on this tester include the $8,950 US carbon ceramic brakes, the Disenio paint, Distronic, and some convenience options. In Canada, there's only one specification and there were no options. Plus, this car in Canada is essentially special order only. It only came one way. As tested in the US, this is $207,945, and the rough equivalent in Canada is $239,900, of course, and that is before delivery and local taxes. In terms of speccing your GTR Roadster, well, there are a couple of considerations. The easy stuff is choosing your options, assuming you can still buy one of these new today. However, the big consideration for me is the tires. If you live somewhere where it's wet and cold, you probably don't want these Cup 2s. If you're not taking it to the track, you probably don't want these Cup 2s. And if perhaps you're not as experienced as some of us, you probably don't want these Cup 2s. So get some Michelins that suit the performance of this AMG GTR Roadster that is a little more livable. These are super sticky, amazing on the racetrack. I'm certainly enjoying them, but I think you do have to have a high skill level to take advantage of these Cup 2s. That is my only thought with respect to the performance package of this GTR Roadster. To me, it comes perfect as it is. For me anyway, this is one of the best cockpits I've ever experienced. You're sitting on the floor. Lots of adjustment in the steering column and the seat. The seat's very supportive and perfect pedal placement. This is a two-pedal car, obviously, but there's a dead pedal for your left leg. Steering wheel is perfectly shaped and finished in this Dynamica material. It's just the perfect setup. Sitting low, sitting behind the long hood, sitting back in the chassis. This is Roadster seating position perfection. Speaking of which, these seats are deeply bolstered. You sit in them rather than on them, which is fantastic. And as well, they're heated and cooled in this particular car. How perfect is that? Lots of adjustment in the seat, but you know, I'm just sitting here seated perfectly. Love it. Forward visibility is great, but that's dead forward. What you have here to the sides are your mirrors, and they actually do take up a lot of visual real estate. It's a little bit more of a concern when you're parking, but not when you're driving quickly. Ergonomics are very much Mercedes-Benz or AMG, and if you're familiar with modern Mercedes-Benz, you're gonna be very at home here. Lots of quality feeling buttons and dials and that sort of thing. It's very straightforward, but where it gets complicated is in the infotainment system and the instrument cluster. There's perhaps a layer or two more going on than what I would like. And you know, this is a performance-oriented Roadster, very much performance-oriented, and I would like a little more simplicity with my infotainment system, that's for sure. In terms of spaciousness, it's a very wide cockpit, so there's lots of room for you and your passenger, but otherwise, storage space is not bad. The door pockets are pretty much useless, but there's a glove box and a storage bin underneath the armrest and two cup holders right here in the center of the console. There's a bit of ceremony when you get into this GTR Roadster to set it up to your preferred drive mode. Sport Plus, soft dampers, manual transmission, and this is just ultra high performance Roadster perfection. AMG says this GTR Roadster will do 0 to 60 in 3.5 seconds. I suspect it's actually quicker than that in the real world. It certainly feels that way. Top speed is said to be 197 miles an hour, and overall, I think those power output figures are a bit on the pessimistic side. Putting down that power is exceptionally easy with these Cup 2s. There's no difficulty putting the power down, whether it's in a straight line or exiting a corner. Furthermore, it is easy to steer this car on the throttle. There's so much power and so much torque, and it's so progressive and so predictable that you can steer it with the throttle, and that is one of the things I love about this car. This motor is a wonderful example of just a pile of power and a pile of torque with the sounds to go along with it. It revs quickly, and of course this transmission shifts quickly, both up and down the box. There's always abundant torque and all the horsepower you could ever need everywhere, all the time. This is just a magnificent drivetrain. One of the most satisfying things for me is when you're in a long corner and it's a long radius kind of corner, so you've got lots of speed going on, you're well into the throttle. Mid-corner upshifts are beautifully perform. They're seamless. You don't upset the car at all. And that speaks to the calibrations of the engine and the transmission and the differential. It doesn't upset the car, making this car very, very approachable for the less experienced driver. But for me, I love it. Getting the power to the ground is not a problem in this GTR Roadster. It does it without complaint. It does it flawlessly. And if you're a little less precise or ham-fisted, as they say, it's not gonna penalize you either. It rewards everybody from someone like me with a ton of experience to the novice driver. It's so easy to drive and so approachable of a high performance package. It is a brilliant piece of engineering. One of the highlights for me is steering this thing. This thing points so positively, whether you're just carving corners, whether maybe you're braking traction at the rear axle and need a little counter steer, this thing is perfect. It steers so well. Again, at low speeds, you've got that four-wheel steering to help you maneuver a little bit better, and then at higher speeds, the rear steer steers in phase, making this feel a little bit more stable. But when you're hustling, it's absolutely rewarding. Just to hold the steering wheel and point this long nose, it's magnificent. The cup twos respond instantaneously. You're always confident of grip on that front axle. You can always point this thing perfectly. It is exceptional to steer. This suspension setup might be on the firmer side, and as I mentioned, I set this up on the comfort damping setting, and that is a wonderful package, especially here on these California roads. They're not perfect, but they're not billiard table smooth either, so you do need a little bit of compliance in the damping, and overall, excellent ride, but handling is really where the shines. When you lean on this car, there is great balance all the time, whether you're entering a corner through the mid corner or exiting a corner. Handling is there. There's tons of grip, tons of confidence when you're pedaling this thing. It is magnificent. For a reasonably conventional suspension setup, there's no trick active anti-roll bars. This thing corners very, very flat and still has a reasonably compliant ride. It's a great mix of handling and comfort and ride quality. Body roll is at an absolute minimum, as is dive and pitch, but there's just enough there to let you know what this car is doing, and it does talk to you in that way. Speaking of which, feel from the chassis is excellent as well. And what is most special about driving this GTR Roadster is this seating position. You're seated so far back in the chassis, closer to the rear axle, I think, than the front. And with that long hood and those front wheels a little further ahead, it's just a very unique driving experience. And that makes this very special in that regard and unique among all of the GTR's competitors. As a dynamic package, this GTR Roadster deserves all of these superlatives. It's fully resolved. Everything works perfectly harmoniously. In terms of a speed weapon, this is a fantastic machine. Very, very confidence inspiring, certainly for me. If you don't have a lot of track experience, this is something that you can work with. Sure, it's gonna be bonkers fast, but you can work with it and improve your driving skill. And you know, this is the thing about this GTR Roadster. It is a complete package. You've got modern comforts and conveniences. It is a modern day Mercedes-Benz in that way. Then you've got this beautiful Roadster driving experience, and then you've got a platform, a drivetrain, a chassis that you can take to the racetrack and absolutely have a blast, be among the quickest on any given track day, and then drive it home. This is just one remarkable piece. AMG really knows how to build a wicked, wicked Roadster. My verdict, Well, at this point in the episode, I'm pretty sure you can tell how much I enjoy driving this thing, and that's for a bunch of very good reasons. Normally, at this point in the episode, we will talk about as-tested fuel consumption, but to be fair, I actually don't care. I just keep putting fuel in this thing because it is so enjoyable to drive, and that's because it seems like it's the best of modern-day Mercedes-Benz. It's the best of what AMG does in one completely resolved package. It's incredible to drive, and to me, it's a masterpiece of modern engineering. I just love this thing. If you get a chance to drive one, don't refuse. If you have the opportunity to buy one, I highly recommend it. It's a wonderful machine. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this Mercedes-AMG GTR Roadster. Hope you liked this piece, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube. You know what to do. Smash the subscribe button. Turn on your notifications, like this, and as always, sharing is caring. So please share this with your friends who you think may appreciate this. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you want to support the channel, hit up our merch store. Links here, links below, and there's lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us or driving enthusiasts that you know. So consider those some gift ideas. There's some free advice for you right there. Go down here, hit up our merch store, have a look. We'd really appreciate that. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves.